नाउ यू कैन स्टार्ट करो ना।
Our talk analysis is DB Laboratory. About company, DB Lab has been established for more than 29 years in Hyderabad with two manufacturing units and is among the top pharmaceutical company in India. It has been recognized as a reliable supplier of generic API and a trustworthy custom manufacturer to Big Pharma and is among the top API manufacturers in the world. It has a portfolio of 120 products across diverse areas. About industry update, India is a prominent and rapidly growing presence in global pharmaceutical. It is the largest provider of generic medicine globally, occupy a 20% share in global supply by volume, and also supply 50% of global demand for vaccine. India ranked third worldwide for production by volume and 13th by value. The pharmaceutical industry was valued at $36.7 billion in 2018. The market is expected to expand at a CAGR of 22.4% over 2020 to reach a $55 billion. QGLP part will be covered by Sanket.
Okay, thank you, Karuna. So coming to the QGLP part, as far as the quality is concerned, DB Labs is considered to be among the world leaders, and especially in the 11 of the 26 active pharmaceutical ingredients. And as far as the promoter share is concerned, the promoters control close to 52% stake in the company, and the promoters have an experience of close to 30 years. As far as the obligations are concerned, the company has never defaulted on its obligations, be it for the financial institutions or to its debenture holders. Now coming to the growth part, the company has increased its revenue share. This can be due to the fact that there has been an increased spending in the pharma sector, close to $1.3 trillion in the global scenario. Even as far as the company's own revenues are concerned, it has shown a significant increase of close to 28% in a year. Coming to the longevity part, the company has been able to maintain its care rating of AA+. Which shows that it is going to be a going concern in the very long future. As far as the product development is concerned, the company is actively involved in developing products for diseases such as epilepsy, anti-HIV, and smoking cessation. So these products are expected to be a path-breaking as far as the Indian pharmaceutical sector is concerned. As far as its investment is concerned, it is expected that the DB's Lab is expected to invest close to 1,200 crores in two big brownfield projects. Coming to the price part, it has a high revenue, stable return on equity, and high operating profit margin, which justifies the fact for its high price to earnings ratio. Its debt to equity ratio also stands at close to 0.015, which indicates that it has a significantly less exposure to the leverage. And as far as earning per share is concerned, it has been able to increase its earning per share from close to 54% in a year. So this establishes its quality, growth, and longevity and pricing part. The remaining part will be covered by Aditya.
Hello.
Yeah.
Okay, next we have the story in graph. As we see in the graph that the revenue is increasing over the year, as well as the operating profit margin, which shows the stability of the company. And the company has a healthy dividend payout, which is around 30% over the year, which shows that the management is looking forward to the shareholders. The financial summary, we can look in that the revenue as well as EBITDA margin has been increasing over the years, and it is expected to increase in the financial year 20X as well. And according to the PAT and ROE, the company is increasing, and in the financial year 2019, the company has recorded 1,332 crores of PAT. The price to earning ratio of the company is around 56.56 in the current year, and in the financial year 20 is expected to around 47.34. The company is maintaining the debt equity ratio around 0.01. So near zero debt to equity ratio, company has been able to manage stable operating margins and increasing PAT over the years. If you look at the peer comparisons, there have been four companies like Divi's, Bluepeen's, Dr. Reddy's, and Cipla. If you look at the market cap, Divi's is the more market capitalization in the four companies comparison. And the sales growth of the Divi's laboratory is the highest. It has 28%. If you look at the ROE and the PAT margin, it is also highest in the comparison of Divi's. So next we have the risk and concerns. If you look at the revenue generation of the Divi's, most of the revenue is generated from the exports. So the company is exposed to a wide spectrum of risks relating to exchange rate risk and the price fluctuations. As for the current scenario, there has been a lockdowns and closures, which shows that the less availability of materials and the high cost of the materials in the imports. So as for the overall conclusion, the ever-increasing global demand of the Indian pharmaceutical drugs, Divi's Lab business cycle is expected to remain steady. Divi's Lab is not much affected by the COVID-19 as far as the demand side is concerned, because the United States and Europe is in a high demand of pharma drugs right now. The company has a healthy balance sheet with near zero debt equity ratio and an increasing profitability margins. So at the current valuation, the company can generate higher returns in long term. Thank you from all of you for listening.
Thank you all.
If you have any questions, you can ask.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes.
Actually, you said it is not affected, but supply chain disruption, there won't be any change in the demand. Like, they won't be able to meet those demands because the supply chain is disrupted due to this corona.
Actually, the demand talking about is that the company might be affected by in the production side or in the supply side for sure. But as far as the demand is concerned, Corona has not been able to make an impact on its in its what it's in its production or in its supply chain. As far as after the product development, product has been developed and it has the distribution of product is concerned to the market.
Hello, am I audible?
Yep.
So I had a question that since that market cap of DV is second largest, I think, after Dr. Reddy's. So India is the largest producer and exporter of generic medicines. So can you again
Yes.
throw some light on how much is the market share or how much contribution market cap has DV's in this area of generic medicines? How much do they export? And how it compares to their peers when it comes to exports? Thanks.
Actually, Divi is not the second largest. We have not considered Sun Pharma industry, which is the largest market cap in the India. So, as well as the market share is concerned, Divi is the third largest market capitalization in India. But most of the revenue generation is from exports. 70% of the revenue is generated from exports.
Okay, and do you know how much of that is generic and how much of that is exotic medicine?
How much of that is generic and
Other expensive medicines.
actually we I don't think we have an idea of
I mean,
the
just
product distribution.
I'm just looking for a comparison with other companies like Dr. Reddy's and Sun Pharma, that how much do they export and how it fares in when it comes to export. That's all. Otherwise, it's very well presented. So that's just one query I have.
Yeah, actually, in the global demand for Indian pharma and drugs are significantly high. You can see that. So yeah, the revenues are significantly dependent on exports, and Divi's Labs is no alien to this. So yeah, majority close to, as Aditya said, close to 70% of its products are exported.
Okay, thanks.
I have one question. What is the average PE for the industry?
Average PE industry is around 36.19.
Okay, so don't you think since this company is trading at a PE of 50 that there won't be much space for appreciation in share price? I think DVS is anyways trading at a very higher price. So what is it that this company is doing, you know, much different than the other peers that it will be able to replicating its performance, past performance?
As for the current situation, the price is high, but in the long term, the price may go up high, as we can see that it is world leader in 11 out of 26 generic produced, as well as the debt equity ratio is near zero. So the financials are good. So price may be expected to high in the long term. So is there any suggestion for the post? Any point that can be added?